Blackstone Publishing presents The Kids of Widney Junior High Take Over the World by Mathew Klickstein. This book is read by Cary, Hite. All charts, diagrams, and photographs that appear in the print edition of this book can be found in the bonus PDF file that accompanies your audiobook CD or download. Stay tuned for two unreleased songs from the kids at the end of this audiobook. After I learn the bass, I'm going to take over the world. Kayene, K-O-W-J-H member. The Kids of Widney High is a raucous rock band composed of members living with various disabilities who sing about their hopes, fears, and dreams. Also cows, insects, and the joy of getting a new car. Having blossomed out of a music class based out of a special education school, Joseph P. Widney High, the group is led by former teacher Michael Monaghan. Among other adventures along the way of producing four full-length albums and playing shows throughout the greater Los Angeles area, the kids were prominently featured in the hit Farrelly Brothers-produced comedy, The Ringer, starring Johnny Knoxville and Katherine Heigl. For more on the kids, please visit www.kidsofwidneyhigh.com. Although what follows is a work of fiction, we gratefully acknowledge the band for allowing us to be inspired by their unique spirit and for their encouraging support throughout the completion of this book. Chapter 1. The New Kid is Not So New. Here are two things that might go through your head if you ever get shoved up against a locker during your first week of sixth grade. 1. Huh, this kind of thing actually happens? 2. Exactly what brand of garbage does this dragon breath monster twice my size holding me up by the neck eat for breakfast? You may also wonder, along with how hard he can squeeze that scrawny neck of yours before your head pops like a grape, gosh, how did I get here? Or maybe you're one of those people who never has to worry about getting shoved up against a locker, or pantsed, or tripped, or forced to go out in the rain and sing the national anthem backward 3 times in a row. Well, it only took me a few days at Whitney before I became one of those people who does get shoved up against a locker. Or at least I was one of those people until I met the kids of Whitney Junior High and watched them on their way to becoming one of the greatest rock bands of all time, which is what my story is all about. You probably already guessed this. Heck, it's the title of this book. Now, you may never have heard of the kids of Whitney Junior High before, but I first got to know them because I go to Whitney Junior High School, where the kids are in the special education program. Me, I'm just in the boring garden variety classes with the rest of the boring garden variety students. Not that there's anything necessarily wrong with being boring in garden variety. It's just that the kids of Whitney Junior High really are something special. Take Pee-wee, for instance. In addition to his autism, he lives with legal blindness. Yet, that guy still sees a whole lot more than you'd think. Just keep him away from your cat, or too much toilet paper. More on that kind of thing later. So Whitney has 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. Being in 6th grade, I'm one of the younger kids. I'm 11. Some of the older kids can get up there. We're talking 13. If you ask me, having the older kids with the younger kids is a little weird. Since no one did ask me, I guess we've got no choice in the matter. If things were up to me, I'd make it so we could watch more movies in school. And you know, good ones. But that's something else again. My parents and I moved around a bunch before I got to Whitney. This means I had to get good at meeting new people quickly. Tips for those who are curious include, 1. Mashing your food together at the lunch tables and eating it, no matter how disgusting it might be. Careful with grape juice and nacho cheese. You'd think that combination would go down easier than it does, but nope, it doesn't. 2. Writing funny little sayings on the chalkboard behind the teacher's back without her knowing it, on your way into and out of the classroom. I find the best stuff in old books from the 1920s. The Marx Bros. Crazy Cat.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.